All right, folks, we're back. I've been really, really busy. As you can see, we got the motor installed, which has been a challenge. You can see my fabricated throttle linkage is all installed. Everything's working properly. We went ahead off camera and turned on the electric fuel pump. As you can see, it's fed by two separate lines. I had a little leak on one of these banjo fittings here, and they use a little felt gasket, and I went through three of these and it still leaked. And I was about to give up and scream uncle, and then I did something. I kind of cheated and put a thin film of a gasket sealer on these and put it in, tightened it up, and no leaks on the fuel system. So then we turned to the oiling system. I went ahead and added 8 quarts of oil and the PTF additive, which is a zinc product, to help break in the motor. We then, with Caleb's help, we had him turn the key on, and as I'm turning the engine, this is what you call pre-oiling. This is just a piece of steel. I showed this on another video. It fits right inside my distributor right here. So anyway, we turned it and we noticed that we didn't have oil pressure on the gauge. So we kept on trying to figure out what was going on, and we just didn't have oil pressure. So it's sent by a sending unit. This takes the hydraulic pressure and transforms it into an electrical signal to the gauge, which is electric. And we just weren't getting the oil pressure that we need to want to start the car. So I went over to Napa and bought a manual gauge and added a couple pieces of piping right here and installed this. Then pre-oiled the engine, and at very low spinning speed, which would simulate idle, I've got over 30 pounds PSI at idle, which is outstanding. And then I increased the drill speed and I got over 70 PSI. So I'm very pleased with my oil pressure system, and that's all ready to go. So after that's done, we'll be installing the distributor and setting it to the number one spark plug and installing the spark plug wires. Once that's all completed and everything's good, then we're gonna connect the battery, plug in the distributor for its electrical signal, and we're gonna fire it up and we're gonna start the break-in process. Your distributor spins your oil pump, and that's how you get your pressure. That's with just about every engine that I'm aware of, that's how the oil pump works. So what we did is we got the oil in here, I've got it hooked up to my drill, and we're gonna turn it, and we're gonna see if we got some oil pressure on the motor to simulate it running. Ready? Let's do this. Look at that. Rev the engine up, more oil pressure. Idling, look at that. So we're really pleased with those results. I think I'm confident enough now to install the distributor. Now, before you set your distributor, you want to make sure your engine is at top dead center. So I have a timing mark down here on my harmonic balancer that when the distributor is perfectly up, that's where my engine is at top dead center. Then what I do is I take a little tool and I go right here in the number one cylinder, and I can actually feel the top of the piston. So I'm verified that I'm at top dead center. Now that I'm at top dead center, I can take the distributor and install it. This must fit into the groove of the oil pump. So as this goes in and this distributor gets turned by the camshaft, there's a gear on it that turns it, and this is how your distributor works. So this will be set inside here, and I'll line it up and I'll make sure I have all my clearances because I have to have room to rotate. And then what I always want to do is set this at cylinder number one. It's just a little trick that everybody does when you set your distributor. You always want number one cylinder on your cap to be pointed to your number one cylinder. So that takes care of installing that. Then we'll go ahead and put the wires on. One more thing that's real important that you want to do, guys, gap your spark plugs. They do not come pre-gapped from the factory. So figure out what your gap is. I use a gapping tool. I gap mine, at about 35, 37,000ths. As you can see right there, about 36, 37,000ths. Also real important, put a little bit of anti-seize on your threads. You'll thank yourself for it later when you need to remove your plugs. They won't be frozen. So we're about ready to plug everything in, and then hopefully the next sound you'll hear is the rumble of the engine. I should have a smile from here to here. Those neighbors over there are going to be really pissed because this is really loud, and we're going to be breaking it in my garage. 2,000 RPM for 20 minutes. They're going to love me. So that'll be the next thing you hear. Instead of my voice, this motor. It'll speak for itself. Later.